Hello everyone, welcome to our channel DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and this is part 2 of the RegEx series. If you haven't watched my previous video, Introduction to Regular Expression, please click on the I button on the top right corner. Now let's get started. In my previous video, I talked about various meta characters and literals which you can use to create patterns and what is the difference between literals and meta characters. Now here I am going to use those meta characters to match patterns and show you how to do that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to import a library named RE. Since it is already in a very small, it is also already a very small name, so we don't need to write as in front of it and change it into R or something like that, or give it a pseudonym in per se. Now once you've imported the library, what you can do is this is again the regular expression library. So what you're going to do is first keep in mind what kind of a pattern you want to match. So here I suppose that I want all the alphabets or all the characters which are here in this pattern. So what I'm going to do is I am going to use a method from RE library that is called compile method, wherein you write your patterns for which you want the sentences to be extracted or the string to be extracted. So here I am using RE.compile and writing a period sign and an asterisk sign. Now in my previous video I told you that a period sign basically is a meta character which helps you match any alphanumeric or special characters. Apart from that, I also told you that asterisk is a meta character which helps you match pattern zero or more times. So what I am doing here is I am combining the two. I am combining this period sign and asterisk sign. And I want all the characters in this sentence or strings to be extracted. So here within RE.compile I write my pattern. So here R means read. The read whatever is within the code as it quotes as it is. Now I'm saving this entire pattern in this variable named pattern. Now on this pattern I'm going to apply match method. So the speciality of match method is that if you're writing a pattern or you're trying to make a pattern to extract certain type of a text, it basically matches only in the beginning of your string. So suppose that you have you want to match a pattern which has a @ sign and an exclamation mark. In that case, I'm taking a lot of reference from that previous video, so if you haven't already, please go and watch that video, if you haven't, then this will create some miscommunication or it can confuse you a little bit. So @ and exclamation mark. For that I told you that you can use \W if you want to match only the characters which are special in nature. So here I have @ and exclamation mark. So for that I'll use \W instead. I'm just giving an example. I will be using this in the compile method. So if I want only the special characters, I can use this particular pattern, right? So we will be doing that again. So first, here what I am doing is that I am writing hello text lab here. This is my text and I want this text to be extracted as it is. So for that I am writing within compile method, I am writing full stop asterisk. That means anything with alphanumeric or a special character should be extracted. Okay, and now on that particular pattern I'm trying to put this text. So for that I am using match method. So what match method again does is that if the entire text is in the beginning of whatever you are trying to match, it will extract that only. I'll just give you an example in a minute. So let's try to see that with full stop and asterisk sign, can we extract this entire text or not? Shift enter. Now with shift enter, you see we have matched the entire string, and it is starting from zero index and ending at 15th count. Okay, now if I change the sign, suppose that I want to match only at the rate. Okay, and this at the rate is not at in the beginning of the sentence but on the at the second index. So now if I run that, now if you want a literal to be matched, like I want at the rate to be matched exactly as it is and I want that to be extracted, so in that case I'm only going to use a literal. And if I want to, you know, match a pattern wherein there is a combination of numbers and alphanumeric characters and spaces and all that stuff from a huge text, then in that case I'm going to use meta characters. So here I have at the rate space hello dexlab. As I said, match method matches or finds something only at the beginning of the line. So if I run this now, I have no match. Now if I store it here in a variable, say a, and then I run it, and then I try to print this a. Let me just put it in the print method. You see, we have none here. That means nothing matched because there is a space in the beginning instead of at the rate. So now let's see that if I change this and bring this at the rate on the first index or the zero index per se, what happens? Now I run it and I print it down. So here I have at the rate matched. So that is the property of match method. Now let's use few of the meta characters which we have previously studied. So I'm not going to use this A here, and I'm also going to remove this cell so that there is less of a confusion. So suppose that I want to match only numbers. So 1, 2, 2 and 3, and I write for numerical values the meta character is / small d. Okay, now I just press shift enter again. There is a no match because we do not have a digit right at the beginning of the sentence. Now we want a digit to be in the beginning. So here I have 1. See, as soon as I mentioned 1 in the beginning, it completely matched this. Now if I write 2 as well, it is only going to match 1. The reason being, we have written here only backslash d once. So as I said before, if you want if you want a range of numbers, or if you want to find a particular pattern that has multiple numerical values, you have to add on that many numerical that many backslash d's. So now if I write backslash d 2 times, here I get 12. Now if I only want this 12 to be printed, what I'm going to do is, like we did in our string extraction or index extraction, we are going to write at the zero index or at the zeroth row, whatever has been found just print that. And here I have 12. Okay, now let's check a few more meta characters here. So now suppose that I just put in an asterisk here and then I run it, then also we'll be able to find this 12, because 12 asterisk means backslash d means asterisk means 0 times or more times. So here now, as you see, we have found 12 here in reality, and here I am using the only backslash d, and not I am not writing it multiple times. So basically this particular pattern says that match backslash d 0 or more times. Now so here you see that combining different meta characters is giving me different results. In our previous pattern, we found that only writing a single backslash d is going to give us 1. Okay, that is one numerical value. Now if I write back 2 times backslash d, it is going to give me 12, because it's matching 12 here. Now if I write a stick right on top of it with a single backslash d, it is going to again give me 12, because it said match digit 0 or more times. So here I run it and I get 12. Now suppose that this 12 is nowhere to be found in the beginning. What will happen then with this pattern? Nothing. It is going to match nothing. But still it is giving me a result. Why? Because it says match anything 0 or more times. So even when there is nothing in the beginning, nothing, no numerical value in the beginning, it's still matching because of the 0 property of this asterisk. So even if nothing is there, in that case also this asterisk sign is going to prove helpful. Now let's experiment with these meta characters. Removing this 12 here from here and 23 from here. E L L O A. Now if you remember, parenthesis, with anything within the parenthesis has to be matched exactly as it is. So as here in the hello word, we do not have A attached to O, we are getting nothing as our result. So nothing is matching in reality. So if I remove that and I just run this, we are getting hello here. So we are saying that you can match O exactly as it is if we have that in question. So suppose that we write hell here, so we get no result. Now if I add a strict sign, that means match O 0 or more times. That means that even if we aren't getting O here, we are still matching hell because we have put in an asterisk sign. Now let's see that changing this will change anything or not. Question mark means anything matched 0 or 1 time. 0 times matched hell. Plus sign, it means I match anything 1 or more times. So in that case, since O is present 0 times in the text, we are getting nothing again. There is a no-match situation. Now let's try to use square brackets. I'm also going to remove this. So suppose that I have OA, A over here. Nothing. If you remember, square bracket matches anything, any character which is within the square brackets, but any one character, not the entire thing, but any one character. Suppose that I have A here, pattern matched, hella. If I have O here, pattern matched. If I have OA here, it is only going to match O, and it will stop right after this A, right after this O. Now let's try and add another meta character on top of this. So let's take asterisk first. 0 or more times, anything matched 0 or more times. So A, O now has this property that it can appear any number of time as we want. So it'll match anything. Now if I add question mark here, question mark means anything 0 or 1 times matched. So 0 is here or 1 time is here, so hello, O is, we are able to match O, so it's only stopping at O itself. Now let's add plus sign. Plus sign means anything 1 or more times. Hella, we already have more times here, as we can see. So that's that. Now again, if I want only hella to be extracted, I'll just write 0 and print. So whatever it finds is stored at the 0 index, and from that index you can just directly extract the string. Now suppose I want only special characters to be found, or suppose I want a pattern which should match only at the rate signs. Or percentage dollar 67, so on and so forth. Now let's first try and extract special characters. Adding asterisk sign, that means anything match anything 0 or more times. We have @ space percentage space $67 and space, but oh sorry, we do not have 67 here, so it's only stopping here in space only. Now suppose that I also want numerical values. Or more times. So I'm just adding a small W, which basically means anything alphanumeric. So here I'm getting 67 as well, and it is stopping just after 67 because we haven't added anything right after that's small w. So we need to make pattern exactly as your data is or your text is. So we have special characters first, then we have numerical value. Now if I want the space also to be extracted, then what I'm going to do is, again I'm going to add a backslash w here, and I'm going to use asterisk just so that if there are more than one, or if there is zero space or special characters or more than one, so I'll be able to extract that as well. So here I have space included in this. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use square bracket, extract them, and I can also use split. So by what you want to split your data, I want it to be split by space. So here I have @, percentage sign, $67, and an empty space added to it. Now, in case I want to include those spaces in the split, we cannot by any means or like that. So suppose that now if I, after the split, I want to extract zero index, so I have @, or I can use for loop to loop these characters. A for I in A, I equals to S equals to S plus EY within quotations, obviously, print EY, and so I also want I to be added. Sure. So @ EY, percentage EY, dollar EY, and so on and so forth. So basically what I did is, I extracted, since this was in the form of a list, I extracted the entire thing, and I did added EY just after the special character. That's it. Now if I want to add space as well, I can just write plus and add space. So this is how you can manipulate your strings, and by extracting them, by making patterns, and then again using it in a for a analysis, right? So that is it for today's video. Hope you enjoyed and learned something from it. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you haven't already, please subscribe and click on the bell icon so that you are notified each time I post my videos. Bye bye, take care, thank you.